Hi viewers, welcome to our channel. Myself, Dr. Veena. Today, we'll discuss on the topic deworming of dogs and cats. Do like, share and subscribe our channel if you find this video useful. As a pet owner, deworming is one of the major aspects which you should be aware of. Deworming means the administration of an anhelminthic drug to make your pet get rid of any helminth parasites, as worm infections can lead to an increased susceptibility to illness and disease. First, let's see some of the common parasites which need to be prevented. The first one is hookworms or ankylostoma species. These are very common in young dogs and cats. Clinical signs include weight loss, diarrhea which is bloody or tarry. Sometimes the worms may be seen in the feces. The point to be noted is that the hookworm larvae can penetrate human skin and potentially cause a skin condition known as cutaneous larva migrans or creeping eruption. Another worm is roundworms, mainly includes the Toxocara species. These are also common in young ones. Infection occurs through ingestion of other infected animals, for example, rats, or prenatal infection. Clinical signs: poor hair coat, diarrhea, pot-bellied appearance. Public health significance is that the roundworm larvae penetrate human skin and can affect various organs in the body, causing mechanical damage and granuloma. The condition is termed visceral larva migrans, so proper hand hygiene measures should be followed. Otherwise, there is chance that we can also acquire the infection from our pets. Another worm is tapeworm. Under this contains the Dipylidium, Tinea, Echinococcus species. The transmission can be through fleas, ingestion of infected meat, etc. This is also of public health significance. People can become infected with Echinococcus and Tinea species by association with infected dogs or infected meat. Another one common protozoan disease in animal is giardiosis. Its clinical signs include diarrhea, weight loss, etc. People can become infected by fecal-oral transmission, which include drinking untreated water. Another one common parasite is Toxoplasma. It is a coccidian parasite which infects cats. It's an important zoonotic disease. Zoonotic disease means diseases which are naturally transmitted between animals and man. If women are exposed to Toxoplasma for the first time while pregnant, their baby can have serious congenital problems. However, most of the people acquire infection by eating improperly washed vegetables and improperly cooked meat. Now, let's discuss about how your pet can get the intestinal parasite. Most of the intestinal parasites are spread through contact with feces or stool. This can happen when your pets eat a wild animal, such as when cat catches mice. It can also happen when dogs eat things off the ground where an infected animal has previously eliminated. The one exception to this rule is tapeworms, which are spread by fleas, as already told. When a dog or cat grooms an infected flea off themselves and eats it, the tapeworm larvae enter their system and builds up. It is normal for puppies and kittens to have intestinal parasites. Older pets are less likely to harbor these parasites unless their immune system is compromised. But they may also have worms if present in their environment. Here lies the importance of deworming. Deworming starts from 15 days of age. The protocol is first deworm at the age of 15 days, after that once in 15 days until 3 months of age, then once in a month during 3rd to 6th month of age. After 6 months, deworming is to be done once in 3 to 4 months. In case of bitches and queens, deworming should be done once prior to mating and once at the time of birth. Lactating bitches and queens should be treated concurrently with puppies and kittens. Many combination drugs are available in the market in the form of suspension as well as tablets. The dosage will be decided by your veterinarian according to the health status and body weight of your pet. Underdosing is not at all effective. So, proper dosage should be followed, as the worm load can make your pet immunosuppressed and susceptible to other infections. And it's preferable to go for combination drugs than a single drug. In case of newly acquired animals, obtain the deworming schedule from the previous owner. Deworm immediately, then repeat after 2 weeks and follow the normal schedule. Hope this video was useful for you. Thank you.